Hello, dear students. How are you today? Today we are going to learn about. Let me share the screen. Sorry. Let me share the screen. Let me share the screen now. Yeah, you can see now. ¿Pueden ver? Yeah. Now we are going to learn about third conditional, el tercer condicional, ¿no? Let's go to learn. The third conditional, it talks about the past. El tercer condicional normalmente habla del pasado. Este es usado para describir una situación que no ha pasado, ¿no? Es para describir algo en el pasado que no ha pasado. Por ejemplo, yo ayer no me caí, ¿no? Y uno se imagina qué pasó en ese resultado. Por ejemplo, yo no me he caído ayer, ¿no? We make the third conditional by using the past perfect. Por ejemplo, yo me he caído, tú has comido, ¿sí? After, if, and then would have. Por ejemplo, después del if tenemos que usar el pasado perfecto. El pasado perfecto. Y después el auxiliar would have, ¿no? Would have, unido, ¿no? Would have. Y el pasado participio en la segunda parte de la oración, ¿no? Por ejemplo, así, would have, ¿no? Por ejemplo, if plus past perfect. Por ejemplo, I, you, he, she, we, would, have, and the past participle. ¿Ya? Let's go to after the definition, let's go to see the example is better, ¿no? Here, how the structure. If, past, perfect, and perfect conditional, ¿no? Yeah. Just for situaciones imaginarias en el pasado. En el pasado. Acuérdense que el tercer condicional es en el pasado, ¿no? Ya. Yeah. Por ejemplo, miren. If I had got. Recuerden que el presente de este es get, ¿no? Si yo tuviera una medalla. Si yo hubiera tenido una medalla de oro, yo podría haber sido feliz, ¿no? If I had got a gold medal, I would have been happy. ¿Ya? Recuerden que siempre tiene que haber en la segunda parte de la oración, I would have, ¿no? I would have. Y el verbo en el participio, ¿no? Been, given. Es bueno aprenderse, por ejemplo, los verbos en presente y en pasado y en participio, ¿no? Por ejemplo, it es el presente. Ate es el pasado y el participio, eaten, ¿no? Eso hay que memorizarse, aprender a memorizarse el vocabulario. Es muy bueno aprenderse el vocabulario. If I had met Susan. Si ven que este en el pasado y had, el verbo had, ¿no? Por eso siempre se utiliza en el pasado perfecto, siempre se utiliza el verbo have, pero el verbo have en pasado es had. If I had met Susan last week, I would have given. ¿Yeah? Vamos a. No, esto ya es para practicar, ¿ya? Vamos a ver let's go to watch a video in order to learn a little bit more, ¿ya? Let me hide this one. Yeah, let me move it on, yeah. You can see the video.
What is the conditional mood in English? We typically use the conditional mood for hypothetical
Let me check if I share it.
situations. When we don't know if something will happen, we make a guess about the outcome. What is the third conditional? The third conditional is also known as the past conditional. We use the third conditional to express a past regret or imagine a different outcome. For example, if I had studied harder, I would have passed the test.
¿Sí ven? Ahí le pone el have en pasado. If I had. Y el verbo en pasado también, ¿no? Por ejemplo, si yo hubiera estudiado duro, fuerte, yo podría, I have, would have. Yo podría haber pasado el test. Podría haber pasado el test, ¿no?
This means that I failed the test, but I can imagine that if the condition of studying harder had happened, the outcome of passing the test would have happened too. In this sentence, I am expressing regret about failing the test. The most common third conditional pattern is if plus had plus past participle, would plus have plus past participle. Note that we use a comma after the if clause. For example, if it had been a nicer day, we would have gone to the beach.
Ya, mire. Utilizamos el condicional if plus el verbo have en pasado, porque y más el pasado, pero en participio, ¿no? Por ejemplo, it presente, ate pasado, pasado participio, eaten, ¿no? Y de ahí el otro sería would have más el pasado participio, ¿no? Por ejemplo, mire, aquí, if I had been, had, del verbo pasado, have, been, es el pasado, pero participio, a nicer day. We would have, siempre hay que utilizar el would have, y el verbo en participio también, ¿no? Por ejemplo, el verbo en presente, go en presente, en pasado, went, y en pasado participio, gone. Gone, ¿ya? Y
the if clause doesn't have to start the sentence. Another common pattern for the third conditional is would plus have plus past participle, if plus had plus past participle. Note that we don't use a comma before the if clause. For example, we would have gone to the beach if it had been a nicer day. Let's look at some more examples of third conditional sentences in English. If he had forgotten his umbrella, he would have gotten very wet.
Si ve, ahí le utiliza el verbo have en pasado, forgotten. Es el pasado participio. ¿Ya?
If we'd known you were in the hospital, we would have come to see you. If you hadn't eaten the whole pizza, you wouldn't have felt so sick. She would have bought a new car if she had gotten a raise. I would have called you back if my phone hadn't died. They wouldn't have bought a new house if they hadn't won the lottery. Look at the picture. Say or write a sentence using the third conditional. For example, I had remembered his birthday. He would not have been so angry. Now you try.
Miren, ahí empieza por la parte de atrás, ¿no? Por ejemplo, if empezaba, por ejemplo, ahora empieza por la segunda parte, miren. The children, ¿cómo iría ahí?
Work.
Would have, y el verbo este en pasado participio, es gotten, ¿cómo iría? The
Would
children.
have gone.
The children would have gotten, ¿no? Muy bien, Wendy.
Children would have gone to the park if the weather had been better yesterday.
¿Cómo iría ahí? Had.
If the authorities had
Sent.
sent.
Muy bien.
If the authorities had sent the tornado warning sooner, fewer people would have been in danger.
¿Cómo iría ahí? He would have gotten the job if he had
Had done.
muy bien, Wendy, muy bien.
Would have gotten the job if he had done well at the interview.
Ahí. ¿Cómo iría?
She would have
Would have.
given.
Muy bien, Joseph.
She would have given a better presentation if she had been better prepared.
Y aquí, ¿cómo iría? Este el pasado es didn't, ¿no? Miremos, a ver.
If I hadn't left my keys in the door, I wouldn't have had to go back home on my break. Thanks for watching.
Yeah. Let's go to do a test. I hope you understand. Let me pass the to the test, yeah. You understood? Let me stop sharing. Sorry.
Make life more rewarding.
Yeah, remember the structure, it has to be the conditional if, past perfect, plus, comma, perfect conditional with past participle. Yeah. Let's go. Yeah. Let me share the screen. Let me share the screen first. Yeah. Let me share the screen. Yeah. Yeah, you can see. Yeah. How you do how can you do these sentences, Jocelyn?
If she have a student,
If she
when you're
had,
eating.
yeah, she have studied, no? What about Wendy, this one?
If I had eaten some
If
more.
I hadn't eaten so much,
I have not had.
yeah, but this one have to go in past, yeah? Hadn't. If I had not eaten. Está bien también, así como usted dice, pero sin contracción. Está bien, ¿eh? ¿Cómo seguir a la segunda parte? I wouldn't.
I
Wouldn't.
wouldn't have,
Wouldn't. Fell.
I wouldn't have
Sick.
felt sick.
Yeah. No me sentiría enferma, ¿no? Yeah. This one, Jocelyn.
If we have
Had
taken
taken a taxi, we wouldn't have
a
missed the
taxi,
plane.
we have what
Wendy, this one.
happened in play.
Este está de lo contrario, ¿ya? Y recuerden que cuando se empiece de la otra forma, no va coma, ¿no? ¿Cómo sería esta, Wendy?
She won't, she
She wouldn't. She wouldn't.
wouldn't have been, didn't if
Tired.
she.
If
If she
had
had
muy bien, muy
gone to bed.
bien. To the bed earlier. ¿Ya? ¿Cómo iría esta, Jocelyn? Este de aquí.
She would have
She would have
become
become
a teacher if
a
she
teacher.
a teacher if she haven't
No, es half nomás. Half.
have gone
Gone to the
to
university,
the
¿no?
university.
La última, Wendy.
He would have
He would have been.
become a, ¿cuál
This
he
one.
would have been
Been.
on time for the
The interview.
interview if he had left the house
At
left.
yeah, had left the house at 9, yeah. I think you understand the topic very well because I didn't write because it's presentation. I hope you like it. Thank you so much. I really appreciate your help.